Where is the skill shortage in IT security?
Yeah.
Where are those shortages?
Yeah, I mean, it's the so-called mythical cybersecurity talent or skill shortage. It really depends on, I'm finding, who you ask and what industries. Like, as a hiring manager myself, in the 5 months I've been with PwC, I would have hired 4 people, and it's been difficult because the areas that we're looking at, senior consultants, sort of managers, so we're looking for maybe 7 to 10 years experience, and we're wanting them to have sort of a broad range of skills, and then have a couple of specialty areas, whether it be something like fraud, forensics, or risk and governance, etc. So what I'm finding from a personal perspective is that it's hard to get 7 or 10 years of cybersecurity skills. And a lot of the people in the market have a lot of technical skills, but then they lack the sort of the risk and governance lens. And particularly then, the soft skills, the people skills as well. But I talk to clients who are hiring as well, areas in terms of like security architecture. So it's really, the more sort of senior, sort of 7 to 10 year range. And even then they're finding it hard in the market to get candidates. And I think it's more of a as opposed to a skill shortage, perhaps it's over demand, not enough supply in the market. Mm-hmm. It comes down to demand and supply.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, because I've actually found that there's been some really good talent in terms of security on the market.
Yeah.
But they have been on the market for a long time.
Yes.
But then I'm hearing constantly that there's a shortage.
Yeah.
Can you explain why that is happening?
So security is fairly broad. It's a diverse discipline. So you've got things, fraud, very specialty things like fraud forensics, you've got penetration testing, security incident response, etc. Then you've got your more generalist sort of skills. So I think in the more generalized areas, we do have a staff there, we can reuse them from IT infrastructure, etc., and they can sort of progress into that fairly easily. But I'm imagining that the people that you're talking about have a very sort of particular skill set. Mm-hmm. And those, particularly here in Brisbane, again, Brisbane is different from Sydney and Melbourne as a market. So those particular skill sets probably don't have as many employers or prospective employers in this market. Because if you look at it, particularly in the corporate space, we have Suncorp, we've got BOQ Flight Centres. There's a limited amount of large corporates, and then there's a lot more in the government space who may not need those specialist skills.
Mm-hmm. Why hasn't it translated into jobs yet?
Yeah. I think that comes down to a lot in terms of maturity of the market. Mm-hmm. I talk a lot with my peers in Asia, in the US and in Europe. Now, I think the maturity of their markets, they have different dynamics, right? They've got a lot more financial services, they've got a lot more large corporations, but they also have a lot more regulatory compliance, etc. Mm-hmm. Mandatory breach disclosure has been in the US for almost 20 years in different states. Europe has a very sort of strong regulatory regime, and they're about to get things like GDPR. So the dynamics in each of the regions are very different. And I'm hoping that we are sort of, we'll see a shift once we start to get, things like mandatory breach disclosure, et cetera, next year.
Mm-hmm. That's in February, right?
That's in February, yeah. And there's a lot of work at the moment going around preparation. We've also got GDPR for all those organizations that do have a presence in the UK or have EU or EU citizens on board. So, and they're, it's not the panacea, that's not going to make the difference, but it will be a nudge in the right direction, I think.
Mm-hmm. So you think that once the security breaches become mandatory, that there will be a pickup in security needs for businesses Australia-wide?
I think there'll be an increase in awareness. In the US, the latest couple of breaches, around Equifax, etc., lost its CEO and CISO. I think those kind of issues will help the maturity and will help awareness.
Mm-hmm.